My name's Matt Herbanis. I'm a sports medicine orthopedic surgeon with Jude Orthopedic Clinic. Currently, I'm one of the providers, team physicians for the Orlando Solar Bears. A knee dislocation is a problem that we describe that happens to the knee. It's a traumatic injury to the knee. If we talk about a little bit of anatomy to start out with, the knee is made up of our thigh bone, the femur, and the shin bone, which is the tibia. And then those bones are connected. They're connected by ligaments. We generally have four ligaments in our knee that hold our knee together. There's the collateral ligaments, which are on the sides of our knee. And then in the middle of our knee, there's the ACL, which everybody kind of hears about. And then the PCL, which is in the back. That's the anterior cruciate ligament and the posterior cruciate ligament. So those four ligaments function at holding the bones together. When someone has a dislocation of their knee, they typically tear many of those ligaments, as opposed to an ACL tear, it'll just be the ACL and sometimes spraining the MCL. With a dislocation is usually the PCL, the posterior cruciate ligament, and then the collateral ligaments, and sometimes all four of them are ruptured and torn with a dislocation. So behind our knee, we have a big nerve that breaks off into a couple branches, and then veins and arteries that bring blood flow down to our leg and bring it back to our heart. When that knee goes through that traumatic dislocation, doesn't happen every time, but there can be injury to the nerves and the blood vessels, and you were referring to the blood vessels. If the artery gets injured, just because it gets stretched, doesn't usually completely tear, but it can get stretched and then there's injury inside of it, then that can block the blood flow to the leg. And obviously that's an emergent problem. The person typically will go to the emergency room. They'll do a arteriogram, which is a radiographic study to look at the blood flow through the artery. And if it's found that that blood vessel has been damaged, then they'll go through a surgery to kind of bypass that damaged area. That's usually done by the vascular surgeons. As a sports medicine orthopedic doctor, kind of our role at that point is typically to stabilize the knee, because the knee is very unstable. So an external fixator will be put on, which are some pins that go in the bones and they're connected by rods. And that kind of holds things in place while the vascular surgery is done. Obviously, the vascular injury is kind of priority number one. We need to save the leg because it could be a problem there. Once that's restored, then those ligaments eventually need to be reconstructed because they don't typically heal. A lot of our ligaments in our body, ankle sprains, wrist sprains, those ligaments heal. We don't have to do surgery. The ligaments around the knee with the dislocation, they're a little different because they don't heal. So in order to regain stability of that joint, we have to go back and reconstruct those ligaments, which means we actually replace those ligaments. We put in new ligaments to replace the torn ones. With a knee dislocation, that's usually done down the road a ways, a couple months. We kind of let all the tissues settle, make sure the vascular reconstruction is successful, and then eventually go back and reconstruct all those ligaments. One of the other structures that can be injured in a knee dislocation is the nerve. Behind the knee supply the muscles in our leg, kind of below our knee, and they also supply sensation to our leg. One of the nerves that typically can be injured in a dislocation is the peroneal nerve, which goes around the outside of the knee, and then it supplies the muscles that really pull our foot up. And the reason why that's a problem is if that nerve's out, then there's what's considered a foot drop, where a person can't dorsiflex or bring their foot up. It's a very important function for when we're walking. So when we bring our leg through, we actually use those muscles to pull our foot up so we can swing our leg through. And when you can't do that, you have to walk and pull your leg up to compensate for that foot drop. Most of the time, these nerves recover with a knee dislocation as long as the nerve's intact. It's a little bit unpredictable. Sometimes they don't recover. That's kind of the first step in a person getting back to walking again normally, is that nerve needs to recover. And then the vascular flow prior to that, and then the ligament reconstruction. So getting someone, you know, back into normal daily activities is an accomplishment, and then trying to get somebody back into a sport is even a bigger accomplishment.